In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use an Angular wrap method to create this mesh. The green and blue decorative meshes were created by a cube that used an array modifier along with two curve modifiers. The original mesh was not curved, and the second curve modifier was used to produce the curved result. This is how the original mesh looks like only with the array modifier. It's a cube that had vertical and horizontal loop cuts, and two side faces extruded along normals. In edit mode, Ctrl R to create four loop cuts like this. Please use the mouse wheel up to add more segments. We can scale the edge loops apart like this, and type S and Y to scale in the Y axis. The selected faces were then extruded along normals, and I removed the faces after extruding. In order to bend the mesh, we must add more geometry into the cube. In edit mode, type A to select all. Right-click and S to subdivide. We need one array and two curve modifiers. I have created this curve circle and used it as a reference object for the second curve modifier. Let's scale the mesh to make it fit into the curve. After that, I used a curve point to create a bending curve object, and used that as the first curve modifier's reference object. I have put this array's axis to X, so it can bend the cube like this. Your result might not look like this. Please rotate the curve or mesh to create this shape before adding other modifiers. Also, please try other axes, if the mesh doesn't bend like this. This was my array and bending result. This is how my curve looks like. Please make sure to move curve slightly away from the origin for a better bending result. This mesh was created by duplicating the original cube, and moving it up on the Z axis. Scaling won't work well as we're still bound to two curve modifiers. After duplicating, type G and Z, and it will scale down automatically. It will also bend further, because the mesh is still following the first curve modifier's shape. After that, I applied all modifiers for the duplicated mesh, and rotated it. This mesh was created by proportionally moving an edge loop of a torus mesh like this. Then I applied random metallic materials to all four meshes, including the ground plane. We can use cycles or EV. I liked the render result of the cycles better for this project. Please use any HDRI images as the environment. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.